October 16th, 2004. The Yankees lead the ALCS 2-0 over the Red Sox with Game 3 in Fenway Park. As in the first two games, the Yankees began by scoring in the first and quickly building a 3-0 lead. The Red Sox answered in the second inning with a leadoff walk by Jason Varitek and a Trot Nixon home run to right field, a double by Bill Mueller, an infield hit by Johnny Damon, his first hit of the series, and a Derek Jeter error led to two more runs. The Red Sox led for the first time in the series 4-3. This lead was short-lived as ARod led off the third inning with a home run over the Green Monster, and the Yankees would build a 6-4 lead. By the end of the third, the Sox would even things up at 6 apiece off a double by Orlando Cabrera. That was as good as it would get for the Sox for the rest of the night. When it was all over, the two teams combined for 37 hits and 20 extra base hits, both postseason records. At 4 hours 20 minutes, the game was the longest 9-inning postseason game ever played. The Yankees destroyed Boston 19-8 amidst chants from Yankees fans of 1918, the last time the Red Sox won a World Series. With a 3-0 lead, things looked bleak for the Red Sox. October 16, 1969, the New York Mets win their fourth straight game from the Baltimore Orioles with a 5-3 triumph behind pitcher Jerry Kuzman, who throws a 5-hitter to take the World Series in 5 games. In the third inning, Baltimore takes a 3-0 advantage after home runs by pitcher Dave McNally and outfielder Frank Robinson. After a strong argument by Mets manager Gil Hodges in the bottom of the sixth inning, Cleon Jones is awarded first base when shoe polish on the ball proves that he was hit by a pitch, and Jones scores on a home run by Don Clendenin. An inning later, Al Weiss ties the game 3-3 with a solo home run, and in the eighth, Ron Swoboda's double and two Baltimore errors give New York 2 more runs and the World Championship. Clendenin is named Series MVP. That was October 16th, this day in baseball.